then we believe Jesus, the eternal God, is in three manifestations. Now, that's the way he gave it to me. That's the way I wrote it. Do you notice how that came out of there? And we believe Jesus, the eternal God, in three manifestations of the same Holy Spirit. Now, there's the qualifications. Come up hither, and the others get in the great tribulation. That's the way God brings it, and they find out who he is, and the Jews do too, finally. Now, so, water baptism by the book of Acts is the way that you do it, in the name of the Lord Jesus. That is the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and we know that. Nowhere did they ever baptize Father, Son, Holy Spirit, and Bible. In the book of Acts, even Paul, every one of them, whether he baptized, he told them how to do it. Peter and every one of them baptized that way. Even Time Magazine brought out they were baptized that way until about 300 years. Now, there I said 300 years after Luther, when I was preaching that sermon on that long. If I didn't get that date right, I'd get it right now. I think maybe I did. But 300 years in something. Even Time Magazine one time backed that up, several magazines. They baptized in the name of Lord Jesus. And at the Nicene Council there, about 300 something years after Christ, they changed it. And it's been in the Trinity baptism ever since. And then Luther followed that through. If he'd only, it wasn't time yet. At the end of the age, they're going to get every loose end and tie it up. It's going to shake loose everything. You know, tradition is dangerous. You can't shake them loose from it. How many of you believe that? But you go back to the original book of Acts. The real qualification now. You go over time. I don't care what you say to these preachers. They will not. And they cannot, saith the Lord, go against that. You won't do it. I don't care what they say. They're not pushing me back at all. It don't matter to me. I sure wish. And I believe that ministers, he's going to give some of them a last chance. Because some of them work hard all their life. And they really thought they were true. And they really thought that. The ones that are going to make it now, he'll cause a change about. The highways and hedges is going to bring some of them in. And that quick, short work, he can probably get just what he wants. And man could work 1,000 years and get little. But the Lord can work in just a little while and get all that he wants. Did you know that? Amen. And so, the eternal God, water baptism, the book of Acts, in his name. Then we have this. Patience. The proper Godhead was given when I started that off. You go back to Jesus there. Now, patience. Even James said just before the coming of the Lord, he wanted people to have patience because they had run out of patience. Everything was erratic. Everything was paranoid. Everything was just like it had been splintered and broken up in different pieces, running here and darting there, as Daniel said, darting back and forth, you know. Knowledge increased at the end, and man would go here and there real quickly. And he said, have patience now. The church that really, for a long time, during the time of the outpouring of the early century, when we begin to get back all that was lost in the book of Acts and the church ages come right on up. And when it was poured out and poured out upon us, ever since then, it's been gradually coming up through the line. And they thought the Lord was coming at each outpouring and each war that broke out, and each time it broke out, modern machinery and all of this, and with the atomic, they thought it was around the corner and the Jews was home and they jumped up and down. But he said, have patience, brethren. Some of those people now are on the wayside. Time killed them. If they had faith, it cannot do it, saith the Lord. How many of you believe that?